My name is Fo. I'm a PhD student in Dr. Mao's lab.
This is my fifth year here at Cornell University. And one of the first projects that I started on, a protein that's related to a bacteria called Legionella pneumophila.
This bacterium can get into a body through contaminated aerosol. Once it is taken up by the macrophages, the bacteria can replicate in our cells and eventually take control over it. As a result, it can lead to life-threatening pneumonia.
It is called Legionnaire's disease. In the United States alone,
between 8,000 and 18,000 people are diagnosed annually.
Once you get infected, the fatality rate is between 20 to 40%. So far, there hasn't been a good drug that specifically targets this bacteria. My research is to study Legionella protein so we can develop better therapeutics to cure this disease. My research career started much later. It was really after college. I grew up in Taiwan. As a kid, I never thought of being a scientist. I want to be a basketball player. And I came to the States in 1995. I'm always curious about bacteria. It really got me hooked. Looking under the microscope, that you can see all these amazing living organisms. After I graduated from University of Washington, I applied for a research technician position. Unfortunately, I was able to get the job and I worked for 2 years. I had a really good mentor who fueled my passion for science and really gave me the confidence to apply to graduate school. And the reason why I'm here at Cornell University.
I'm fortunate to be doing research at Mao Lab Institute for Cell and Molecular Biology. This building is designed to allow for open collaboration and communication among different labs. So as a graduate student, it is a privilege to have this environment where you feel very comfortable talking to a leading scientist in their respective fields. To study bacterial protein, you can actually manipulate the bacteria to mass produce your protein and biochemically purify them. The entire process requires molecular cloning, growing your bacterial cells in large quantity, and for me, a lot of discussion with my colleagues. The entire process can take up to 1 to 2 months. But when you see your purified protein, it's an amazing feeling. And it really opens the door for a lot of experiments by
structural biology approach, also cell biology.
Right now, I'm using mammalian cells to study the role of proteins that are secreted by Legionella. Cells are typically preserved at below freezing temperature. However, once they are thawed, they have to be kept at a special incubator. Most of the experiments are performed in the fume hood. The reason I use these cells is so I can engineer a fluorescent tag to my protein and use confocal microscope to look at exactly where the protein is located inside the cell. In my first 3 years here,
I was interested in protein structure. What I find fascinating about protein structure is that you can figure out the shape.
At the atomic level, the method that I use is called X-ray crystallography, which requires protein crystals that are only formed under very limited conditions. But luckily, there's a robot that helps with this. Once you see the crystal, you can shoot X-ray beam through it to obtain very useful structural information. And using that, the three-dimensional structure can be revealed.